It's an educational video by Ken IPSS Sultanpur, UP. I am Dr. Rachna Yanga, Assistant Professor, Department of Zoology. Dear student, I welcome you all in my zoology class. Today I am going to teach you about the topic chordata. Now, the animal kingdom, which is divided into several phyla, approx 30 phylum. So one largest phylum is a chordate or chordata. The phylum chordata, which is created by Balfour in 1880. The phylum chordate, which is derived from two Greek words. One is chordae, it means string or cord, and ate, it means bearing. So chordata means cord bearing animals. So in this chordata, the one biggest animal is the blue whale. Its scientific name is Balaenoptera mucullus. Balaenoptera mucullus, and its length approx 35 meter, weight is 120 ton. The smallest animal is Philippine goby fish, Pandega, and its length is approx 10 millimeter. Now, what is the classification of chordate? The phylum chordate, which is divided into two groups. One group is Acrania and second group is Craniata. The Acrania is also called protochordates or lower chordates, and the Craniata, it's called eucordate, and it is a higher chordates. Group Acrania or protochordates, which is further divided into three subphylum. One is the hemichordata, number two is the urochordata, and number third is cephalochordata. The hemichordata, the subphylum of hemichordata, is further divided into two classes. One is entoponista and second is pterobranchia. The subphylum of urochordata, which is divided into three classes. One is Acidacea, and second is Thalesia, and third is Lavacea. And cephalochordates have only one class, that is Leptocardi. And the subphylum vertebrates of higher chordates group is further divided into two division. It's two division of vertebrates. One is the Agonatha and second is Gnathostomes. So Gnathostomes is further divided into two superclass. One is Pisces and second is Tetrapoda. The Pisces is divided into five classes. One is Ostracodermi, second is Cyclostomata, third is Placodermi, and fourth is Chondriochthyes, five is Osteochthyes. And the superclass Tetrapoda, which is divided into four classes. Number one is Amphibia, number two is Reptile, number three is Aves, and number four is Mammal. The Ostracodermi, Cyclostomata, Placodermi, Chondriochthyes, Osteochthyes, and these are actually lower vertebrates. These are lower vertebrates, and reptilias to mammal, these are higher vertebrates. Those vertebrates are differentiate higher and lower on the basis of one embryonic membrane, that is amnion membrane. In those, this membrane is present is called amniota, and those membrane was not present is called anamniota. Now in the next slide, this diagram shows the three basic fundamental characters of chordate. One is dorsal hollow nerve cord, second is the pharyngeal gill slit, and third is the notochord. The position of dorsal hollow nerve cord is on the dorsal side of body, and pharyngeal gills which are present on the ventral side of the body, and notochord which are present in between the dorsal hollow nerve cord and pharyngeal gills, or above the pharyngeal gills and below the dorsal hollow nerve cord. So these are three fundamental characters: dorsal hollow nerve cord, notochord and pharyngeal gills. Now next. Now here is the detailed characteristics of chordate. Number one is the notochordate. It is the longitudinal cartilaginous rod which are running between the nerve cord and digestive tract, and they are act as a support for the nerve cord, and it is replaced by the vertebral column after the embryonic stage in all vertebrates. Next is the dorsal nerve cord. These are the bundle of nerve which are running along the back and split into the brain and the spinal cord. It is hollow and they lie dorsal to the nerve cord. Next is the pharyngeal gills. They are the opening which allow the entry of water to the mouth without entering the digestive system. The all chordates have these opening on a lateral side of the pharynx at some stage of their life, but they disappear in maximum of chordates during adult stage. Other characteristics of chordates like bilateral symmetry, triploblastic coelomy and segments. The body design is complex and well differentiated, and body has a organ system level of organization. Now phylum chordata, which are divided into two groups. You've seen already in my previous slides two classes. One is acrania and second is craniata. Now this slide shows the difference between acrania and craniata. Acrania or protochordata is exclusively marine. A good example of protochordata in your syllabus is Hardmania and Amphioxus. In a protochordata, the head, exoskeleton and appendages are absent. Coelomes are enterocelic, which are formed during embryonic development from archenteron. The notochord is persistent. Skull, cranium, these all are absent. Pharynx have a permanent gill slits. Endostyle is also present. Heart is without chamber. Blood corpuscles is absent in a blood. Kidney is a protonephric. Sex is separate or may be united. Reproduction by the process of sexual and asexual both. Development is indirect. It means having a free swimming larval stages. And craniata or higher chordata, they are aquatic, terrestrial, and they are mostly large size vertebrate. It have a usually two pairs of appendages and exoskeleton is also present. Coelome is cyzocelic. Cyzocelic, it means this type of coelom is formed from the splitting of mesodermal cells. The notochord covered or replaced by vertebral column. Skull and cranium are present and are well developed. Pharyngeal gill slits or gill cleft persist or disappear during adult stage. Endostyle is absent here. Heart is made up of two or four chambered. Kidney, meso or metanephric. Sexes are separate and development to the indirect or direct process both. Now move in the next. The group acrania. The word acrania, which is formed from the two Greek word a, it means absent, cranion, it means head. And if we discuss about the protocordates, so protos, it means first, chordae, it means cord. They all are marine and small in size. They are primitive chordates. They have no cranium, no jaws, no vertebral columns, and no paired appendages. The acrania is divided further into three subphylum. One is hemichordata, number two is urochordata, and number three is cephalochordata. Subphylum hemichordata, which is derived from the Greek word hemi, it means half, chorda, it means cord. So, body divided of hemichordate into three regions. A good example of the hemichordata is a balanoglossus. So, the body of balanoglossus, this is divided into three parts, proboscis, collar and trunk. In this case, the notochord is doubtful and it is non-homologous with that of chordates. So, we move in the class number 1, entrognosta. It also derived from a Greek word enteron, that means gut, pneustos, that means breathe it. Entrognosta. Body is large, worm-like, gill slits are numerous and paired, and alimentary canal straight. A good example of this is a balanoglossus. Number class 2, pterobranchia. Pterobranchia is also form a two Greek word. One is the pteron, and it means a feather, and branchion, it means a gill. The body is a small and compact. Gill slits, one pair or none. The example of pterobranchia is cephalodiscus. The class number 3 is planktosphoridea. It is transparent and it are specialized tornaria's larva which possessing extensively branched ciliary band. Next is class Graptolita. It is the fossil graptolites. It is abundant in Ordovician or Silurian period. Next, the subphylum Urochordata. You also called Urochordata as Tunicata. Urochordata is derived from a two Greek word, aura, it means a tail, and Latin word corda, it means cord. Notochord and nerve cord in a tail only in a minute free swimming tadpole larva. So these features are shown only by the tadpole larva. It is the larva of Hardmania. Adult sac-like, covered with tunic, often transparent, usually no notochord, nerve cord reduced to ganglia. The best example of this subphylum Urochordata is the Hardmania. So, Urochordata is further divided into three class. One is Acidacea. Acidacea is the sessile tunicates. They are not move one place to another. They are stable in a one place, or they are attached to the substratum with the help of foot. And overall bodies is covered by the tunic. It is the leathery covering or test, and also have a scattered muscle in a tunic. It may be colonial or may be compound. It have a gill slits. They are many in number. They are permanent. And the best example I already tell you, that is C squared or Hardmania. So other examples is also represent this class, Molygula and Ciona. Class 2, Thalesia. These are free swimming tunicates, have a circular muscles band in tunic. The best example of this class is Salpa or Doliolum. Class 3, Larvacea. they have a, in this animals, they have a not any tunic. It's the main basic features. And these class are represented by appendicularia and oikopleura. Now move next slide. Cephalochordata. Cephalochordata, which is derived from a two Greek word. One is cephala, it means head, and Latin form corda, it means cord. Notochord and nerve cord, which are present throughout life along entire length of body. The best example of this subphylum is Amphioxus. Amphioxus have only one class, and this class is represented by the animal which is Amphioxus. Class Leptochordi is body's fish like, and these are transparent and segmented with numerous gills like. They are free swimmer and burrowing. Now move next. In this group is a craniata. It is aquatic or terrestrial. They are usually large in size. They are higher chordata or vertebrates. It have a distinct head, vertebral column, jaws and brain, which are protected by cranium or skull. It have only single phylum, subphylum, sorry, that is vertebrata. Subphylum vertebrata, it's derived from the Latin words, vertebratus, it means backbone. Notochord replaced by a vertebral column or backbone. Whole body is divisible into head, neck, trunk and tail. They are usually dioecious. Vertebrata is the largest chordata. This slide shows the difference between Agnatha and Gnathostomata. Agnatha have a absence of two jaws and also absence of paired appendages. But in case of Gnathostomata, it have a true jaws and also have a paired appendages, that is pectoral and pelvic. That is the basic difference between Agnatha and Gnathostomata. Agnatha is derived from a two Greek word. One is a, it means not or absent, gnathos, it means jaws. So they are jawless fish like vertebrates or without true jaws and paired limb. The class of Agnatha, the one class is Ostracodermi. The Greek word ostracon, it means shell, and derma, it means skin. Several extinct order of ancient primitive heavily armed. They are world's first vertebrate and they are called ostracoderms. Next class, Cyclostomata. Cyclone, it is a Greek word, cyclos. It means circular, stoma, it means mouth. Body is like long cylindrical, skin is smooth. They are without scales and jaws and lateral fin. Mouth are rounded and sectorial. Gills are present, which are 5 to 16 in number. Heart is two-chambered. They are basically parasites or scavengers. The best example of this is a Petromyzon and Myxin. Next, we move to the next slide. Here is the division. Gnathostomata. Gnathostomata, which is derived from the two Greek words. Gnathos, it means jaws. Stoma means mouth. Jawed vertebrates having true jaws and paired limb. Gnathostomata is further divided into two super classes. One is Pisces and second is Tetrapoda. All the fish and fish-like aquatic gnathostomes in a superclass is a fish, whereas all the four-footed terrestrial vertebrates, is called tetrapoda. These slides show the difference between piscis and tetrapods. Piscis are exclusively aquatic gnathostome vertebrates. Paired limbs, if present, they are as a fins form. Median fins present, skin usually moist and scaly, respiration aquatic by gills. Sense organs functional in water. In case of tetrapod, they are aquatic or terrestrial. They have a paired pentadactyle limbs present. Median fins are absent. Skin usually dry but not cornified. Respiration is by aerial mode. And sense organs is functional. The superclass Tetrapoda, which is derived from two Greek words. One is tetra, it means four, podos, it means foot. They are land vertebrates with two pairs of pentadactyle limb and cornified skin with lungs. Superclass tetrapods have one class is amphibia. In a Greek form, the amphi means both, bios, it means life. Larval stages usually aquatic and they are breathed by gill. Adult typically terrestrial and they respire by lungs. It have no any external scales and it have two pairs of limb. Heart is three chambered. The good example of amphibians is Bufo, Ambystoma, Rana. Next class, Reptilia, Latin word reptiles. It means covering. Terrestrial and aquatic tetrapods. Skin are dry, which are covered by ectodermal horny scales, or you can say scutes. Limbs usually four, each with five clave toes and have a bony skeleton. Heart is incomplete, have a four chamber. They are cold-blooded. The example of Reptilia is a Sphenodon, Crocodilus, Hemidactylus, etc. Superclass Pisces. The Latin word Pisces, it means fish. Fishes are fish-like aquatic form with paired as well as median fin and have a gills and scaly skin. The class of Pisces is Placodermi. They have a several extinct order of primitive earliest jaws fishes of Paleozoic with bony head shield. They are also known as placoderms. The example of Placodermi is Clematius. Next class is Chondroichthyes. The Greek word chondros, it means cartilage, ichthys means fish. Mostly are marine. They are cartilaginous have a cartilaginous endoskeleton, skin with minute placoid scales. This is the basic features. Gill slit not covered with operculum. Mouth have two nostrils. They are present in a ventral sides. The best example of these chondrichthyes is Scoliodon or Chimaira. Next class, Osteoichthyes. Osteon, it is a Greek word. It means bone. Ichthys means fish. They are freshwater and marine. It have a endoskeleton is a bony. And scale are placoid. They all are bony fishes. The best example of this class is Labio or Protopterus. Next, Aves or Aves. The word Latin is Aves. It means bird. body is covered with feather. The forelimb is modified as a wings, usually adapted from flight. The hind limb basically used for walking, perching or swimming. No teeth in a beak. Heart is four chambered. They are warm blooded animals or birds. Example like Columba, Gallus, Struthio, etc. Class, next class is Mammalia. It's derived from Latin word mamma, means breast. Body usually covered with hair. Skin have a various type of gland. Female have mammary gland. The basic features of mammalia is the mammary gland, which secrete milk for suckling the young. And heart is four chambered. They are warm blooded. The best example is the echidna, rattus, homo, macropus, etc. Thank you.